Coming up, Karen Duffy tries to teach two enemy nations to make tango, not war.
I said $1 million.
Oh, I heard what you said. No, I wouldn't give it up for $1 million.
There's cash.
Yeah, probably. I don't know. Probably I would.
Well, you know, Argentina, remember they lost that Falklands War?
Yeah.
Right? Well, now they're offering the people of the Falkland Islands almost $1 million if they'll become part of Argentina. See, I think Argentina got it all mixed up. They should have gone over to the UK, right? To England, Wales, Scotland, offered a town there $1 million. See if they'd like to come over, be part of Argentina.
They probably would have taken
it. That's right.
You think so?
Sure.
Well, we decided to go over there and find out. Watch this.
The Falklands are a group of barren, sheep-filled islands off the coast of Argentina that belong to Great Britain. They are a desolate, windswept place. But Argentina wants them, badly. So in 1982, Argentina invaded the Falklands. Britain responded with force. And 1,000 dead soldiers later, the Falklands were still British.
Private Dixon.
But Argentina still wants them, worse than ever. So Argentina has floated an unusual offer. If the Falkland Islanders vote to become Argentine, each one of them will get almost $1 million.
What we've heard is £450,000 per person, which is almost $800,000.
The higher the number, of course, the more tempting it will be for the Falklanders to vote for Argentine sovereignty.
Ironically, the guy who came up with this idea, Sir Alan Walters, worked with British Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher during the Falklands War. Now, though, he's pushing an idea that's been embraced by the Argentine government.
A family of four here would receive 3.2 million.
I mean, this isn't peanuts. You get the jackpot wad.
A very big carrot indeed.
I was impressed by the idea of replacing armed conflict with a cash buyout. There's only one problem.
It's a bribe.
I wouldn't accept their money, to be honest.
I'm afraid I think that Alan Walters is very badly informed.
We don't want any trap with him.
The vast majority of people here are deeply offended by it, irrespective of the amount. You are talking about the sale of birthrights, of heritage, and they're not prepared to do it, and I don't blame them.
In fact, according to a survey, 93% of the islanders rejected the offer outright.
There's no accounting for taste.
Sir Alan's plan for peace was doomed. But wait, there was one hope left. Why let a good idea go to waste? If Argentina has all this cash and wants some British turf, why bother with these sheep-loving ingrates?
No way.
Anyway, the Falklands are just a puny protectorate.
It's a godforsaken place.
I thought we could find a part of the real Great Britain that would go for the offer. A place like Mardi.
What's new, pussycat? Whoa, whoa, whoa. What's new, pussycat? Whoa, 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 whoa.
Not only does Mardi have the same population as the Falklands, it's located near the birthplace of my favorite singer, Tom Jones. There's no sheep, but there are plenty of dogs.
And to make sure the residents went along with our plan, I brought along Carlos Novotny, founder of the Argentine Society of New Jersey.
Hola amigos, ¿cómo están?
We asked the people of Mardi if they would consider becoming Argentine for almost $1 million.
Yeah. That's all right.
Yeah.
You think that's a good idea?
Yeah.
Now, I'm surprised that you all were so willing to accept the £500,000 so immediately to become Argentine. Why is that?
None of us got any money up here, are we? Mm-hmm. There's no jobs up here, nothing.
And do you think if you gave another government a chance, do you think that's a good idea?
Well, yeah.
It seems that in the 80s, while the British government was pouring millions into defending and rebuilding the Falklands, it was closing the coal mines that employed the majority of Mardi's citizens. Mardi was now part of the poorest county in Great Britain. So Mardi's citizens clearly had some good reasons for rethinking their Britishness.
People of Mardi, we are here on a mission of world peace. Is there room in your heart for almost $1 million U.S. cash? Is there room in your heart for world peace?
It was time to unleash our secret weapon, Carlos. With the help of this former professional boxer's Latin charm, even Margaret Thatcher might be tempted to turn Argentine.
Would you like to be Argentinian if we offer it to you?
I wouldn't mind, but I'd rather be one.
I'd stay here.
You'd stay here.
But I'd be an Argentinian citizen.
Yes.
You never hear about tango? You heard about tango. The dance, our delicious barbecue, flank steaks,
sausage, blood sausage, with a beautiful Argentinian wine. You know?
And when he taught Marty how to tango, they were ours.
Okay, then.
Viva Marty! Be happy! Be Argentinian! Do you like to be Argentinian?
Let me tell you something. My government will not close your pits.
You know, you'll have to learn how to speak Spanish and possibly learn how to tango.
You got a tanguera de great.
No, but leave the camera. That's not the corner. The left to the phone. Okay? You say one,
one,
two,
two,
three, dos.
But we still had to show the Argentine government that Marty had what it took to be a part of Argentina.
Yo, so Argentino!
So while Carlos taped the proceedings, Marty got down to the business of becoming Argentine. The Argentine flags were waving in the breeze, and within hours, Evita Perón herself would have felt at home here. The people of Marty were doing such a good job becoming Argentine, I felt they each deserved almost $1 million. Now, I just had to convince Argentina to give it to them. I went to the Argentine consulate armed with a videotape, a musical gift, and the hopes and the dreams of the people of Marty.
All I'm going to do is...
No, please.
I'm just going to give you a tape. It's a little videotape. You can watch it at your leisure. You can take it home.
I'm very sorry. We will not receive any paper.
You don't have to accept a paper. You can just accept the Tom Jones record. Unlike the Falklanders, these people are willing to accept $800,000 cash and become Argentine.
Do not insist on that.
You have no right to do this.
Unfortunately, the Argentines were a little less than enthusiastic. I left the video and the gift in the hope they'd change their minds. They didn't.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone.
As far as I'm concerned, it's Argentina's loss. The people of Marty would be a great addition to any nation, not just TV Nation.
I wanna die. It's not unusual to be sad with anyone. But if I ever find that you've changed at any time, it's not unusual.